worldwide. That's a short overview of our registered users. So we have kind of four customer segments: project developers that are planning developing projects, then the investors that are investing in projects, banks, project finance banks, and the fourth segment is advisors that are somehow somehow into the transaction process. Then here what you can see is how we went from really European projects to global projects. When we started, or when we had the market launch 2 years ago, we were mainly focusing on Germany, France, and some projects in Norway, because we had our network there. And what we saw now in the past 12 months around, when we started that inbound marketing concept, then we experienced this global transfer. We see that all around the world we have projects that are modeled in Greenmatch. And we could convince the first customers in South America, Asia, and Africa this year. And those clients were touchless, so we could reach them with inbound marketing. They came to our website, signed up for a free trial, and bought a license without even having a call. The key for our inbound marketing approach is our blog. So we're trying to generate interesting blog content, also country-specific content, to reach customers in other countries without having to travel there. So, for example, last year we had an article about the Argentinian market written by a partner of us. We did some online marketing in Argentina with Google AdWords, Twitter, and so on. And we immediately had 2,000 to 3,000 website visitors. And then we had some registrations for marketing Argentina without even having to go there. Yeah, that was a short overview to Greenmatch. Now I'm happy to answer your questions. Yeah. If you have someone.
What size projects do you have normally in your system?
It's from small PV projects to up to offshore projects, and you have one to with offshore projects. But on average, they are between, I would say, 5 to 100 megawatts.
Okay, that's quite large as well.
So just maybe went a bit fast for me, but are you actually trading then the energy itself? It has nothing to do with infrastructure. Basically, whether it's wind generated or any kind of alternative way of energy generated, you're trading actually the energy produced from one source to another.
Maybe it wasn't clear. It's a financial model for transaction of renewable energy projects. So if someone wants to buy a wind farm, for example, you can do all the valuations, the financial valuations, without a tool.
Okay.
So we're not into electricity trading, but into asset trading.
Oh, see. Okay. So you've got the funding and financing for some of those wind farms in the North Sea, for example. They would come to you, or they could actually...
They could model the project with our software, exactly. So we provide the platform, do not model it for them, and they ask, we will support them, but our idea is to give them the framework to model it, and they can do it themselves.
Okay. Do you find, being located in Switzerland, having a European market, having an international market, any reflections on whether this is the right place to be, the wrong place to be?
Well, I have a similar meaning or similar understanding that yes, its salary is really high, especially if you have most of Germans in Europe. But we are located in Basel, maybe salary is a bit lower than in Zurich. We have a development team in Zurich as well. But it's hard to find new developers, as you said. We were lucky to find three 2 years ago. But it's definitely hard to find good developers at a reasonable price. sector.
From the customer perspective?
There I think it's an advantage because it's really sensible data that is in our platform, so being able to say that our servers and everything is in Switzerland, that our software is developed in Switzerland, it's a plus.
For sure. What's your financing history then? Like, you've been around for a couple of years now. Have you guys raised money, or how did that all work?
Yeah, we founded 5 years ago. We were founded by a family office in Basel. By now, we raised 4.1 million. We are now in a new financing round. We raised around 700,000.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we expect break even in 2021.
Thank you.
What's the actual business model?
So our customer, they monthly license fees, so they rent the software for the financial asset controlling. We're planning to have a different business model that's more volume based, so they would pay per megawatt. So we have those two business models.
Great. Thank you, Zvigas.
Thank you.